you have two options, option A and B, and you don't know which option is performing better, A-B testing is a technique that allows you to decide that. Let me give you an example. Atlik Technologies is a software company owned by my brother. They have this contact button at the top right. Contact button allows them to generate sales lead because a website visitor, if they want to develop a software, they will click on contact button. Now, a business manager in Atlik proposes that we should move the contact button in the middle because that way it will generate sales leads. Now, we live in a world of data and we don't use intuition. So what Atlik will do is they will prepare an alternate version of the website where the contact button is in the middle, and they will run both the versions in parallel for, let's say, 10 days where the traffic is divided equally between both the versions. Let's say website is getting 10,000 users every day. Now 5,000 users are visiting version A where the contact button is at top right. The remaining 5,000 are visiting version B where the contact button is in the middle. At the end of the day, they calculate the sales lead. Less than 10 days, version A got 300 sales lead, version B got 400 sales lead. Now they can conclude that version B is better because that allowed them to generate more sales lead. Now it is not as simple as it looks because you need to consider number of factors. Factor number one is there a sampling bias? What I mean by that is the 5,000 users who are visiting version B, maybe they were from the same area where Atlik already has an established name, and that would be a case of sampling bias. You need to distribute your load randomly so that, you know, people from the random region are visiting the participating in version A and B in an equal way. That way there is no bias. You also need to make sure there are enough samples. You can't run this experiment for 1 hour and let's say 500 user visits your website. Based on that, you make a conclusion. That will also not work. We'll cover all of these things in detail, including what is called statistical significance, in a separate video. But my point is, you want to make sure you are not arriving at a conclusion just by a random chance. Now, A-B testing is something that is used by most of the website whenever they make change in their layout. For example, Amazon repetitively uses A-B testing, and I'm going to provide a link of a research paper where they have shown how they use A-B testing to design the tabs, you know, the product category tabs in Amazon website. LinkedIn, Facebook, any app's website, whenever they want to make a layout change, they use A-B testing. A-B testing is used heavily in data science and machine learning as well. Product recommendation on Amazon is a classic case. Let's say you are a data scientist working in Amazon and you have built a machine learning model that makes product recommendations. So if you're visiting one product, you see some other product recommendation at the bottom. Now, you are deploying a new version of this machine learning model. You won't go ahead and just directly deploy that. You will do A-B testing, which means you will deploy your algorithm on a separate instance and you will have percentage of your traffic going to the new version for some days. It doesn't have to be 50-50%, maybe 70% traffic goes to the current version, 30% goes to the new version. Then you measure the success of the new version after a certain amount of days. And again, you have to take into account the random chance. And all of that is done by hypothesis testing, which again we'll cover in a separate video. But at the end of the day, now you can make a conclusion that version B is better or not. And based on that, you can deploy that to pretty much all the users. Now you'd ask me, why only A-B testing? Why not ABC or ABCD testing? Well, you can do it. The contact button that we have at the top right, we can put it in the middle, we can put it in a top left, and maybe run three versions and call it ABC testing. And that's perfectly valid. But A-B testing is more popular because when you have two options, it becomes very easy to test things out. As you add more options, your experimental design gets very, very complicated. Hence, A-B testing till date remains the very simple, very powerful technique, and people use it throughout the industry. Facebook ad campaign, for example, social media ad campaign is another classical example where you will run your ad campaign. Let's say I have, for example, $50,000 budget for my product, you know, to spend on social media campaign. What I might do is I will run maybe two ad campaigns on Facebook, $25,000 each, and or let's say initial phase $10,000, $5,000 each, and I will design two separate campaigns which will have separate ad layout. Maybe my demographics configuration is a little different, and by running those experiments I can figure out which ad campaign is performing the best, and then I can deploy rest of my advertisement money on my ad campaign. So it's a very powerful technique. I hope you like this video. If you have any question, please post in a comment box below.